Engineering preserves a piece of Central Florida's past. Today, crews moved heaven and earth to move Winter Park's historic Capen House, transporting the treasure across Lake Osceola. WESH News' Michelle Meredith went along for the ride on this one. Michelle, is the mission accomplished?
Mission accomplished, and here's where the Capen House sits right now. It's about a third of the way to its final destination, and its final destination, I'll show you, it's right at the top of this hill. It's not every day a house is moved by barge across a lake, but this is not any house and this is not any city. The Capen House was built in 1885, one of the oldest in Winter Park. When word got out, the house had been sold earlier this year and was earmarked for demolition. Winter Park's historical community rallied, raised over $500,000, and hatched the plan to float it from one side of Lake Osceola to the other, to its new home at the Alban Palaszczuk Museum.
The only option to move the house was by water. The tree overhang along Interlochen Avenue, as well as the narrow streets, make it impossible to move the house any other way.
Watching one half of a 200-ton house set sail, well, it was high entertainment. Boaters, kayakers had front row seats. What do you think about this?
It's incredible. Absolutely incredible, moving a 100-ton house across the Lake Osceola.
The house is being moved in two parts. One half is called Fred, the other called Ginger. Right now they're moving Ginger. They were named Fred and Ginger because engineers will have to do a little dance to put the two back together. And Winter Park has done this dance before. In 2001, Casa Feliz was moved from Lake Osceola to the Winter Park Golf Course. Now, Palaszczuk was a famous sculptor who called Winter Park home, and back in the 60s, his home was turned into a museum. They always wanted a place to have meetings and have art classes and weddings. Now they have that with the Capen House. Now, part two, Fred. Fred will set sail on December 21st. Live in Orange County, Michelle Meredith, WESH 2 News.